described and captioned media program. In the classroom and on the go. DCMP.org.
TMW Media Group presents Spacefiles, Far Out. In computer animation, points of light move through blackness.
How do we measure the universe?
The points look like shards as they drift closer.
Astronomers describe it in light years, the distance light travels in a year.
A larger disc-shaped body nears.
This galaxy, Andromeda, is 2.5 million light years away. Its light takes 2.5 million years to reach us.
A similarly shaped galaxy appears.
Our own galaxy, the Milky Way, is 100,000 light years wide.
The view goes into it.
Just think of it. In 1 year, light travels 9.5 million million kilometers. Such distances only make sense as light years.
A bright yellow sphere gets closer.
Our Sun, for instance, is 30,000 light years from the galactic center.
It passes by.
But the first key in scaling the cosmos is closer to home. It's the diameter of Earth's orbit around the Sun, almost 300 million kilometers.
The Earth is shown, then some stars.
The figure helps us calculate the distance to neighboring stars. So do their color and mass, plus their true intrinsic brightness compared with their apparent brightness.
A line is drawn from the Earth to a star.
In Earth's orbit of the Sun, here's our view in January of a nearby star.
The Earth keeps moving.
As our orbit progresses, the star appears to shift in relation to the background stars much farther out. At the other side of our orbit, in July, the shift is quite measurable.
Another line appears, forming an X.
By factoring in the shift and the diameter of Earth's orbit, simple trigonometry gives us the distance of the star.
The view moves outside the galaxy again.
The technique is called stellar parallax. It works for stars out to several hundred light years, but that's far short of the whole galaxy and the halo of globular clusters that surround it.
A crowd of lights around a core gets less dense further away.
A globular cluster contains up to 1 million stars. They swarm towards the core 1,000 times closer than in our part of the galaxy, and they're ancient. The oldest could be 11 to 13 billion years old, predating the evolution of the main galaxy.
A few different clusters are shown. Short blue smudges appear in a night sky.
The blue smudges are satellite galaxies of the Milky Way. Visible by naked eye from the southern hemisphere, they're the large and small Magellanic clouds.
One is viewed by a telescope.
Both are rich in young, highly luminous stars. This is the large Magellanic cloud, the LMC. Within it, in 1987, the death of a massive star.
A round light glows.
A supernova flash. In fact, the explosion was 160,000 years earlier, for the LMC is 160,000 light years away.
The described and captioned media program provides services designed to benefit students who are blind, visually impaired, deaf, hard of hearing, and deafblind. These services include a library of free loan described and captioned educational media, a clearinghouse of information related to educational media access, a gateway to internet resources related to accessibility, and a set of guidelines for adding descriptions and captions to media. There are no user registration or service fees. Visit the DCMP at dcmp.org. The DCMP is funded by the U.S. Department of Education and administered by the National Association of the Deaf.